This is the audio stream that's coming through.
Oh my God, do you see the scroll? This looks like the Matrix.
Hi, YouTube. The following interview took place August 6th, 2019 at Twilio's Signal Conference in San Francisco at Moscone West. It previously aired on our Signal TV broadcast over on twitch.tv/Twilio. In this interview, Kris Gutta from Twilio sits down with Corey Weathers to talk about Twilio's new product, Twilio Media Streams. I hope you enjoy this interview and live coding session.
What's up, friends? Welcome back to Signal TV. Super glad to have you. It's your boy, Corey Hurricane Weathers. I am here featuring one of our, we kept this like a secret. We didn't tell people what was gonna happen because we wanted the keynote to happen. Shout out to all of our friends who tuned in to the keynote earlier today. And so we've got our first Twilio product session. And this one's all about media streams. And so I'm super excited to have Kris Gutta with us here right now. What's up, Kris?
How you doing, Corey?
I'm hanging in there. How about yourself?
Great. Great.
We've been talking a lot about Twilio. We've been excited about the keynote. We're really excited to see some things happening here on the stream. And so before we jump into that stuff, I have to ask, how's your Signal been?
It's been fantastic. I mean, I'm just love being at Signal.
Yeah.
I get to see customers that I interact with day to day in person.
Yeah.
Like, I get to see my colleagues that I talk to frequently in person. So it's just incredible. I just love Signal just because of how we can interact with everyone. So well, it's amazing.
This is our first time kind of doing this experience where we're taking pieces of Signal and taking it home to our friends from around the world.
Yeah.
We've got folks joining from the UK and other parts of Europe. We've got folks joining from Florida and other parts of the United States. So it's super good to have all of these folks here, which is exciting.
Yeah, I gotta say, when you first mentioned that we're doing this, I thought it was an incredible idea to be
Thank
able
you.
To stream content from Twilio at the Signal to the world.
Yeah.
And I was first to sign up because I thought it was exciting.
That's great. Yeah. And so we're excited to have you.
Yeah.
It's now time for us to talk about one of the things that got announced earlier today during the keynote, Media Streams.
Yep.
Can you describe what it is for the person who has no context, missed the keynote?
Absolutely. So first, I'm a product manager from Voice Team. So mm-hmm. I work with a lot of our voice customers. And as you can imagine, if you're familiar with Twilio,
we have
one of those customers.
Hey, guys.
Hi. Hey, Jonathan. How you doing?
What's up, Jonathan?
Yes.
Friends, this is Jonathan Dion. He's VP of Engineering over at Global. Kris was just talking about how we legitimately have, we're going to get him in the shot here.
Yeah, let's get
him
there.
He was just talking about how he uses Signal to connect up with customers.
Oh, yeah.
Who he doesn't always get to see. And so it's super good to have you popping into the booth here.
Yeah, it's great to see you guys. I mean, we're really excited for this new product. It's going to help us a lot, you know, with our call center. And yeah, we couldn't be happier to be here talking with Kris. Or we just finished talking actually at the session.
Yeah.
But you know, being part of this, it's been a great experience.
We love how excited you are about this.
Yeah.
We really can't wait to get you all on the stream. So next time we got to make sure we schedule your own time.
Yeah, of course. All right.
Thanks for popping in.
Thanks for stopping by.
Yeah, good to see you.
I love how excited he is. And we didn't even really get to jump into the product yet. This is going to be amazing. You all should have the same excitement.
Jonathan is amazing. He's a great customer. As you can imagine, this is the kind of relationship that we like to have with our customers where they feel like they can come in and talk to us anytime and have that interaction. And
absolutely.
That's what Signal's great.
That's what
Signal's
for.
It actually really builds these type of relationships with customers and different developers around the world, where they can feel like they can contact us anytime.
No, I absolutely love it. I love that he felt so comfortable to just pop in here. I love that we got him a little bit on the mic, even though we've got lapel mics.
Know,
this is
yeah.
great. Anyway, let's get back into it. What is Media Streams? Let's talk about it.
Sure, so in simple terms, imagine that me and Corey are talking to each other, and that's a call that's going through a Twilio platform, let's say connected to Corey. With the media streams, what you can do is, as we're talking to each other, you can actually fork the media, the actual RTP of the phone call,
whoa,
and receive that over WebSockets.
Really?
Right. So you can imagine, you can do a lot of different things.
Yes.
Like, you can transcribe that call.
Right.
Imagine it's the same conversation that's taking place between a Uber driver and a passenger, or a contact center agent and a customer.
Mm-hmm.
You can transcribe these conversations
in real time. Oh my God.
Right? So once you have the transcription of what's actually happening in real time, you can do a lot of different things.
Yeah.
One, you can analyze the content of the transcription
mm-hmm.
to analyze sentiment. Mm-hmm. Is there negative sentiment in the conversation?
That's right.
Right? And so you can actually then, you can do this across thousands of calls. It's all automated.
Yeah.
And then so you can surface conversations where if there's a stressed customer or there's an agent that needs help, pop that up to your supervisors so they can jump in and help.
Yeah.
Because today you do that very manually. And another thing is you can extract the intent of what the customer is saying,
mm-hmm.
push information to the agent. Here's a classic example. Imagine that you're in an Uber or Lyft or driving down the street and you saw a rent sign or you saw a for sale sign.
Mm-hmm.
You called a number. Mm-hmm. I said, hey, I was driving down on Bush Street and Bush and Powell, mm-hmm. and I saw there's a house for sale. I'd like to know more about it.
Oh my God.
Right? So as you're speaking, imagine the agent that is answering the phone get the results of all the open houses on Bush Street and Powell.
That is so amazing.
It basically reduces the amount of time it takes to help customers, and it just creates a better experience.
Oh my goodness, this is amazing.
It is. I'm like, I gotta tell you, it's been exciting just working with this product from the very beginning and launching this product.
Yeah.
Just because everything we've done so far has been APIs that gives you functionality.
That's right.
But the media streams, we're giving you a raw audio.
Absolutely.
So you can just build whatever the use case that may be. You can build voice authentication, so you can actually authenticate over voice sound of your voice instead of capturing credit
card
information.
That's exactly right.
And there's a lot more possibilities. For example, Jonathan is building something to analyze background noise.
Wow.
So that he can basically detect if there's an agent that has the background noise in a very noisy environment. He can remove that automatically from routing so that agent doesn't get calls
under
the situation is addressed, which basically streamlines your customer experience.
That is amazing.
Yeah.
Oh my God, can we see a demo?
Yes.
Okay, so we're gonna bring up Kris's computer. I wanna give a quick shout out to Layla Kodzit, who came in. It was the hand of God who fixed our panel here. You all were calling it out. Thank you, chat room. Also, really quickly, before we hop to the demo, I wanna say a quick thank you to a number of followers who just followed the channel. We've got a Straw Hat Raider. We've got I'm Brotep. We've got Lordum96, as well as Money Montano. Thank you so much for hitting the follow button. If you like what you're seeing, if you like what you're hearing, if you want to follow the Signal conference experience for the next day and a half, hit that follow button. You'll know when we go live. You'll see our schedule of content and all the amazing live demos and interviews to come. Okay, let's get back to it. So here's Kris's computer.
Yeah, so I have a couple of demos that, as Corey was talking, I was like, oh, what demo should I show?
Yeah.
So I'm gonna show two demos.
Ooh.
One, I'm gonna just dive right into something that I've already built, so it just saves us a little bit of time, so I can do a second demo. What I have here is a simple studio flow. So if you're not familiar with the Twilio Studio,
mm-hmm.
it's our visual builder that our customers can use to drag and drop and build your voice application.
Oh.
So in case you're wondering, I can write code, but I decided to use Studio today just because it's just simple and easy to visualize.
Well, it's super simple to follow this.
Right, exactly. So here I have a simple flow. It says when you call, say please hold. And then what I'm doing is I'm basically taking the phone call and forking it three times.
Whoa.
So three independent forks, right?
Really?
Yes. So one fork is gonna go over ngrok, our favorite tool.
And we love ngrok.
And come to my laptop,
mm-hmm.
so you can actually see the stream going through.
Mm-hmm.
Another one is gonna go directly to Google Cloud. So that from Twilio, it's go to Google Cloud, it's gonna transcribe,
and that's
it's gonna show the transcription.
That's exactly right.
And the third one is going to AWS, where I'm basically putting the stream into SQS, so that later on I can create multiple consumers to analyze audio and
roll. This is amazing. And we're doing all of this in Studio.
We're all doing all of this in Studio, and you can see there's a say that just by text-to-speech. Here's
uh-huh.
the stream one, if you can see. I'm zooming a little
bit
here.
We'll zoom just a little bit.
Yeah, there you go. And then so that's basically sending it to Google.
Uh-huh.
This one's going to ngrok, and this one's going to AWS. And then I'm parking the call in a queue because if the call ends, the stream disconnects.
Oh, cool.
So for now, I'm parking the call in a queue.
Got it.
And I'm just gonna publish this.
And we're publishing this. So what happens when we publish this flow?
So what happens now is so far everything I've been doing is a draft. So when I publish it, whatever I've been working on becomes live. So that when I make a phone call, the new flow takes an effect. So this allows you to make changes and save it and publish it later,
right?
Without having to break your application, right?
Oh, that's cool.
That's really the key here. And I already had it wired to a phone number here, so I'm gonna quickly make a phone call.
Oh, we're gonna call that number.
We're gonna call that number.
Okay.
Would you like to call?
Oh, I would love to call.
Do it. So I have an ngrok running here, and I have a simple. Let's see where I am right now. Okay.
By the way, I love that we're in the terminal. Do you mind bumping up the Zoom a little bit?
Not at all. So, by the way, the code I'm showing you right here is something that's available for you all to use. We have a public GitHub repo with code samples.
Nice.
So to get started with media streams, once you have the repo, takes you like 10 minutes.
Oh my goodness.
Or less to start transcribing
it. 10 minutes or less. Now you heard it here. Listen, if it's not 10 minutes or less, don't blame me. Blame Kris.
That's right. That's right. So I have a simple web page here, no bells and whistles. And sorry, let me just point you the number right here.
Yeah. So we'll call this number 505-539-2147. Now we've just broadcast this to the internet.
I know.
Let's see how this goes.
I'm a product manager, not engineer, so I don't write scalable applications. Thankfully, we have engineers for that. But as you can see, this is the audio stream that's coming through.
Oh my God! Do you see the scroll? This looks like the Matrix.
And go ahead and say something, Corey. Well, there you go. Your transcription.
Oh, look at that! It's trying to figure out what I'm saying, and it's doing it live. And I am not even doing anything except calling into the number.
That's right.
This is crazy. Oh my God, I'm shocked. We've just seen the Matrix. We're now doing a live call. Let me hang up before we continue.
And here's the SQS. As I said, you have also the messages that are actually in SQS. So you can process them at a later time with multiple consumers.
Oh my goodness.
We're really, like I gotta say, I get excited every time I do a demo of this API because I am super excited. My weekends are now actually consumed on what can I do, what kind of demos I can build.
With the media streams.
Yeah, I should have brought it today. I built a Raspberry Pi car.
It's called
Pi car.
You bought a Raspberry Pi car.
Yeah. So you can actually stream audio to it and then have it move forward, backward, and all that stuff. I just didn't bring it today, but I just couldn't. So I had to do something.
Okay, well, I got to ask two questions. Before I do, I got to say, you said you got excited. The chat room said, Corey just got shook. I sure did, because I saw the Matrix, and I never thought I would see the Matrix in real life in like a way that actually worked. But I got to ask the question, because folks are asking, what is it that we see here in the console? Is it the same thing we see in SQS?
Yes. So absolutely right. So what I'm showing you here is just to give an example that so when we fork the media and stream, we're kind of sending it to you in a sort of a developer-friendly fashion. So mm-hmm. it's a JSON mm-hmm. payload that comes to you every 20 milliseconds with the basic data. So it has enough for you to know what the call is. There's a unique SID. As well as audio packets. By the way,
everything has its own unique SID.
Yes, the stream
has
unique SID.
Its own unique
and then
SID.
You have a chunk number that you can use if the messages are arriving
for
out of order.
For the specific chunk. Oh right? My goodness.
So if you have a distributed system, you can put them in, like for example, in SQS, things don't always go in order, so you can actually use that to order the items. One thing really cool is when you're silent, you just basically see something like this. So you can actually see analysis of this. So this is when you're speaking. Right, so this is actually audio data when
and
you're
then
speaking,
there goes silence.
And then silence, and then this is all silence.
Oh, this is amazing.
Right, so you can do signal analysis, you can do lots of different things. We have customers, as I said, looking for background analysis.
Yeah.
So one thing I was gonna show was this morning, I actually disabled a sentiment analysis aspect of this.
Okay.
I don't know if I get to show you that, but what I was gonna show you was, again.
I love that we're doing it live, friends. This is how we do the things, the most dangerous demos, we do them live.
And then, so I just basically disabled it. So I was gonna show, for example, if I find the right thing. So right here, I basically said, do that, and then I save. And then all I have to do is.
Now we're deploying this to gCloud.
Yeah. I should have done this at the very beginning because it does take a little while for it to spin up the new stuff. But essentially, you get the idea. So now the whole thing is running that is auto-scalable.
Mm-hmm.
And so this is a page that basically comes up from that. So maybe, for fun, if you have a few minutes here, I can just show you on my laptop, Corey.
Sure do. You want me to call back in?
In a second, actually.
Well, while you're doing that, there was a good question that came into the chat room, and I thought it's a good question for us to answer, which is, so we did this off of a phone call.
Mm-hmm.
Will this also work through like audio on, say, a WhatsApp call?
So it will work on any call that is active within Twilio. So if you're familiar with the Twilio, mm-hmm. as long as you have a call SID, and the call is active, you can fork the media.
Okay.
So that includes WebRTC calls, SIP calls, PSTN calls.
That is amazing.
And very soon, you're going to also be able to do that with video calls. So you can actually fork the video stream as well.
That is amazing. Thank you for that question, C-Sharp Fritz, and welcome to the stream. Super glad to see you here. I love that we've made this accessible, easy, kind of to consume and use.
Absolutely. So let me see if this works. We're doing it live, so I...
Do it live.
Let's see. All right, so go ahead and call back in, and perhaps, Corey, you can show some emotions about how you're feeling about this, and so we can actually... let's make sure that actually is working.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I am so excited to be here on the Twitch TV screen with Kris. I'm really excited. I'm hoping that we get a happy face. We haven't gotten a happy face yet.
You gotta pause for a second here.
But we've paused for a second.
There you go.
And there goes our happy face. Now, Ellie Face has asked us to get mad. So I'm going to say that this is disappointing. This is hurting my feelings. And now we've done this in real time. Oh my God.
Are you also very angry?
I am very angry. Oh, look at that face. Look at the shock here. So when Corey tries to feign anger, this is what this looks like. Thank you, Kris. I love how this goes. This is amazing.
Yeah, so what's happening is I was only doing sentiment analysis on a completed stream. So if you don't pause, then it's going to continue to transcribe.
As one stream.
As one stream. And then once that's done, we send it over. But I think you get the idea. The key here is that you can take the text and do a lot of different things
that's
with
exactly
it.
That's exactly right.
As you can see, there's a profanity filter on. So
that's good. Yes. So it catches the things.
Absolutely.
Okay, so I got to ask. Folks are asking, you know, as we start to think about how to get to the next steps here. Folks are asking, how can they get their hands on this today?
Yeah, it's easy. So two things. One is we have API docs publicly available.
Okay.
And second, our wonderful Devangel team has put together a quick tutorial.
Shout out to the other Devangels
on
the team.
That's right. Craig Dennis, big shout out. He's amazing. He helped me put together a tutorial.
Okay.
So once you start from the beginning to the end of the tutorial, 5 minutes in, you're up. You're up and running.
Wait, we have another guest, friends.
Oh, no, Ricky. Oh, how are you doing?
Hey. It is Ricky Robinette, friends. Now, if you caught the keynote earlier, Ricky was our fun friend who decided to kick off his shoes and throw down his luggage.
I love
at
that.
At the end of the keynote, it was a ton of fun. Ricky, we're glad to have you on Signal TV.
Yeah, I don't want to interrupt, but I did. are you all talking media streams?
We were.
We were talking media streams.
How amazing are media streams?
We just had a ton of fun with sentiment analysis on media streams. Talk about the amazing things that
that's
you can
how Corey
do.
Looks when he's angry.
Yeah, yeah, I've seen that. The hurricane gets going.
The hurricane has fiend anger, and there, that's what you get.
Yeah. I was also showing how you can easily deploy into Google Cloud with one step, but it's taking a while because it needs to spin up an instance. But I think, I'm excited, as you can imagine, with Media Streams. It's an amazing product.
Yes, I am excited too. I'm super glad that you had the chance to stop by. I got to ask Ricky, since he's here, Ricky, the chat room wants to know, did you get your shoes back?
I did. I was really nervous, but thank you. Thank you for hearing.
They were concerned. I see the question there.
Yes.
Revertibles. Ricky did get his shoes back. I just wanted to make sure we all knew.
Yes, thank you all.
Hey, thanks for stopping by, Ricky.
Thank you.
And we're actually about to move over to our next guest. But before we do that, we're going to say a big thank you to Kris.
Thank you, Corey.
Hey,
listen, amazing.
You are super popular. Ricky stopped by. Jonathan stopped by. I wish our next guest would be so popular. Let's see, friends.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for everyone joining.
Listen, we've got some more content coming up. We have what we called a hidden session. Our next guest is going to be another phenomenal Twilio employee, a person by the name of Ashley Roach, who's going to spend some time going over one of the products that we saw earlier today, we all got really excited about. That is the Twilio CLI. So join us back here in about 12 minutes. We're gonna get started 2:30 p.m. Pacific time. And until then, it's your boy Hurricane Weathers. I'll see you soon.
Thanks everyone.
If you like what you saw in this interview, please consider heading over to twitch.tv/Twilio and giving us a follow there. We'll have more content like this there very soon.